You just request that person to read your email, request this person to respond back or to give a review. Okay, so please do not ask any delivery receipts to the participants. Do not ask to recall a message. Yes, we happen to do this sometimes. You might have, you know, send a wrong email to wrong people or write people to wrong email. So that time what we do, we try to recall the message. So I think that's not a good practice, buddy. If one or two person already have seen that email, that would lead to conflicts again. Believe me, guys. Okay, so if the participants or your colleagues, I mean, you're close to the team, if you still, whatever may be the case, you better say, please ignore my email, and rather ask them to follow the latest conversation. You know, we have an option to recall a message in Outlook. And guys, I hope everyone are with me, at least.
Yeah, Abdul.
Yeah. Yes, please, sir. Stop me if you're not able to follow, okay?
Sure, sir.
I will definitely forward this PPT to you guys also. Okay, you can go through, right? Yeah. So
yes.
Yeah, thank you. So do not copy a message or attachment without permissions. Okay. So yeah, I think we need not to give more attention here, but still better do not copy any context. You better type your own message. Okay, use a meaningful subject. Very, very important, guys. Subject should be very meaningful. Okay, if you would like to send across an email which is carrying a highest priority, okay, again, this should not have a continuous attention. Someone is unmuted.
Muted.
Yeah. So, use a meaningful subject. Try to use a subject that is meaningful to the recipient as well as yourself. Tomorrow morning, if you want to search that email, the subject should be meaningful. For example, request for a project ID or requirement ID, UID status. Okay, or a request for clarification on so and so, or emergency, okay, underscore or a hyphen, okay, project deadline, so and so date, or emergency, need your response, emergency, need your clarifications by so and so date, okay. Very rarely people use emergency or urgent, okay, only the I haven't used this emergency or urgent word because that would give, you know, a hard figure. Rather, I use highest priority, okay, a top priority, okay. I write an email such a way, subject may, UAT feedback follow-up 2, UAT feedback follow-up 3, and if I still don't receive the response, priority UAT follow 4 underscore top priority or highest priority. My dear customer, dear John, understand you have a lot of I appreciate that, you know, you're doing a good follow-up, rigorous follow-up to that team to complete the UAT, but you know, we have a tight deadline. You know, if we don't come, we don't receive by tomorrow end of the day, that would lead to our project. Guys, always keep remember, don't put I or myself. Always keep we are. Okay, do not say my project deadlines would impact. Always say our project deadlines would impact, because that person also involved in the project, right? Sometimes when you send an email, of course you might have done some requirement gathering, something of a requirement elicitation from the customers. When the customer asks, when the project manager asks you, take the name as we. Yes, project manager, we have completed documenting this path. Because while writing documentation, it's not only you that know complete it. You will take help of solution architect, you'll take the help of testing person, you'll take the help of data analyst, right? So better you take we. Okay, of course, you are the accountable person, again, I'm telling you, but we better use these phrases so that we'll be in a phase of moderate email, moderate person or a friendly person. Avoid using urgent. That's what I discussed. Avoid using urgent, important. Rather, you use priority. Okay, avoid long sentences. Try to keep your sentences to a maximum of 15-20 words. Email is meant to be quick, medium, and requires a different kind of writing than letters. Okay, so it's not every time possible that we have to stick with the 15 or 20 words, but ensure we should not draft an email, draft a lengthy emails. Okay, if you have 10 points which you need to answer, that might take you a half a page of email. So better you divide in a bullet points, then write it. Or else assume 10 questions requirement, 10 questions asked by the opposite person. You take the 10 question, copy to you the next email, or better what I suggest, send an email in such a way, dear so-and-so or dear customer, please response, please review my comments in green, please review my comments in purple. Okay, so that the person go down and read that context rather than in copy the bunch of email again, that will lead to the size again. I do that. Don't send or forward emails containing libelous, defamatory, offensive, racist, of course, we never did it, by sending or even just forwarding these emails, you or your company can face court cases. Yeah, we should be honest with the complaints. So at least BA don't involve here. Keep your long language, gender. Yeah, use CC. Apart from using he or she in an email, we can also use a natural gender. We never use he or she, rather we take their names. Okay, so better don't use he or she, even your project side or a business side. Use CC properly. Try to not use CC field unless a recipient in CC field knows why they are receiving copy of the message. We also understand this point in our business, in our workshop of business analysis, right? Keep a CC to the person who is also involved in the project, right? So for example, you have received a clarification from a QA person, okay? Then send that email to the proper product manager or a project manager and CC to this guy, okay? And then again, if you want the QA lead also have to know this particular conversation, loop him also, okay? So if you don't want this conversation to be read by this participant, just remove them. Okay, sometimes they need not necessary to go through by the clarification, by some conversations, until unless they get concreted. So I think this is, these are the things we have discussed. Be concise and to the point, answer all the questions, use proper spellings, make it personal, answer swiftly, as soon as possible, within 24 hours, do not attach unnecessary files, use proper structure and layout, do not use high priority, do not overuse the highest priority option. Some people write in capitals, don't use capitals also, okay? That's not a good practice to write in capitals, that will give you a bold figure while reading the email. Read the email before sending it, yeah. Do not overuse, reply to all. I think I gave an example here. Excuse me. Check in with abbreviations and emotions. Be careful with formatting. Do not request a delivery and receipts. Do not ask, recall a message, do not copy a message or attachment without permission. Because sometimes we